What's up, everybody? Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Movement Momentum. I'm excited to see everybody joining us this evening. We got an amazing lineup, amazing conversation happening with our leaders around the state. We are about to kick things off. I thought somebody had theme music for me. I thought I heard that. Getting started in just one moment. Yeah, as a matter of fact, I wish I had known that, because we are going to have some music. They don't have me sitting in here quiet. That ain't going to work. All right, we are about to get this thing started, y'all. We're excited about this movement momentum here in the state of California. This amazing work that we're about to kick off and show, share with all of you. And if you're hopping on, man, go ahead and share this on your Facebook, share this on YouTube, share it with your people. We want everybody to join us for this celebration of the amazing work that we're about to do here in California to keep this movement in motion. Sorry, y'all, I'm having some technical issues on my side. We're about to bring it back. Hey, y'all. So I'm excited to be here. My name is Tanish Hollins. I'm the Executive Director of Californians for Safety and Justice. Welcome to the Movement Momentum Gathering and Celebration. We are looking for our folks to join us. We see folks are popping in right now. Please, please, please click the link to join us on Facebook at Safe and Just. If you're online, go ahead and share it. We are excited to have our time done and CSSJ leaders here in the state join us. We're also going to be having more of a conversation around what's going on with our bills, what's happening here in the state of California, and what you can expect over the next couple of weeks as we move things forward here in the state to get these wins. We have changes we need to make for our families, for our communities, and we're excited about that. So the goal of tonight, we're going to be connecting with y'all to give you an update on what's happening with our historic bills, SB 299 and SB 731. We have a fight ahead of us, y'all, but we're not giving up. And it's important to have all of you involved in this conversation, in this movement to make this change. So we are definitely going to be talking more about what that means, how we're going to build this relationship and build this power collectively throughout the state of California with our Time Done members and with our CSSJ survivor leaders. We got a lot of amazing people on the line with us tonight. I want to make sure that we get this kicked off right. So we got to bring in my brother Gilbert Johnson. There you go. You got to come off mute.
It was what it ain't. What's happening, y'all? Thank you for opening us up. Tanish, the amazing Tanish, y'all. Give her a round of applause, y'all, because she is holding it down on so many fronts. I mean, true leader, heart on her sleeve, just really committed to this work, this amazing movement that we are building, all of our policy, all of the organizing, everything. Tanish, you just embody so much Black greatness and excellence. I definitely look up to you and appreciate your leadership. What's happening, y'all? It's Gilbert Johnson, the California Time Done Manager, tapping in. Thankful for everybody that is here right now. Thankful for everybody that is making phone calls. Thankful for everybody that's hopping on Twitter and sending emails and showing up at monthly and weekly and multiple meetings a week to hold it down, to hold down the fort or hold it up, whichever which way you want to put it. We are doing amazing things, y'all, and I have to bring up one of our solid brothers out of the Central Valley representing Fresno specifically. This young man is on fire. I mean, you know, in organizing and building power, you have to have that fire in the belly. And this brother, Christopher Washington, is definitely that 100%. He is a member and leader within our Time Done Delegate Program, the inaugural delegate program that just actually ended, y'all, this month in October. So be on the lookout for the next delegate program application, which we will be launching early January 2022. Super exciting, y'all. Super exciting stuff. One of a kind, game changing, all of that good stuff. And so I'm going to bring up Brother Christopher Washington, who's doing amazing work all over California. This brother is connected, y'all, from the Bay. He done been in LA, San Diego, Bakersfield, Fresno, Stockton. I'm really excited about this brother's leadership and everything that we're doing with CSJ and on the Time Done movement side. And so our very own Christopher Washington will be providing a little bit about his story connected to Senate Bill 731, and he'll give some clear updates around this policy, this transformative policy, and the fight to get our people free, y'all. This is freedom work, y'all, and I'm glad to have everybody here involved with this work, y'all. What up, Chris?
What's going on, Gilbert? How you feeling? How you doing?
I hope that energy is translating. I got
it. You know, I'm gonna bring it today.
I got sick babies. It's keeping me up all night, everything, but I'm here. I'm fired up. This work keeps me amped up. You keep me amped up, and everybody on Good. Facebook keeps me amped up. What's up, big head? All right, I'm back.
Oh, hey, y'all. I'm over here signaling somebody who's about to come in my house. But my name is Christopher Washington, and I serve as, you know, the delegate out of the Central Valley region. And I want to just give y'all a little update on SB 731. So number one, I just want to say that we're not really going to get into the weeds of the politics that took place at the end of the session. That's a whole nother conversation for a whole nother time. But I am here to empower you guys to continue to step up your game and, you know, to continue to organize. And, you know, we have the power to continue organizing and stepping up against these, you know, oppressive systems that are seeking to challenge us. So I want to first talk about the timeline of what's going on. The first year of the 2-year legislative cycle, it came to an end on September 10th. On September 10th, our sunset bill by Senator DeRazzo unfortunately did not pass the assembly floor. So basically what happened, we needed 41 votes. We got 36 votes, but that's okay, because we're not going to let the politics stop us and what we got to do to continue to fight to free our people living with all of these convictions and barriers. But let me just, before y'all be like, oh, it didn't pass, our bill is not dead, okay? We just simply ran out of time and we encountered some things that had to do with politics and really didn't have anything to do with the passing of this bill. So I'm here to let y'all know that SB 731 is alive and it is active. And we're going to continue to work hard to move the bill along in January. And so what we need is you know, all the powerful people to come together, and we're going to all put our hands and feet to the grind, and we're going to push it through. And I believe that we can push it through and that it's our time to do it now. So just to get into, you know, some of the language of the bill, we know that SB 731 will expand automated review and granting record relief to felony arrest records and specified felony convictions. So let me break that down, because that probably y'all are like, huh? So basically certain felonies and certain nonviolent felonies and all misdemeanors where this bill is going to be able to grant people the relief for them to be able to start all over again. So there are almost over 40,000 different barriers that convicted felons face, and this particular bill will alleviate most of those barriers. It will also expand conviction relief by way of petition to all felony convictions. So basically what that means is if you have a felony conviction, you can still petition to get your record clear and you can still move forward in the process. Number two, we don't need to start the process all over again. And that's why I said our bill is not dead. It's actually alive. And we're going to go to the floor, the assembly floor. So where we stopped off, a couple of weeks ago, we're going to start right there again in January, and they're going to vote. Then after, we're going to pass the assembly floor, and we're going to go back to the Senate for a final vote. That's called a concurrence vote. And then after the Senate bill passed, after we get the concurrence vote in the Senate and that passes, we're going to go to the governor's desk for him to sign it. Before we get to my next point, I want to say that the governor can do three things. Number one, he can sign the bill. Number two, he can not sign it, and then after 30 days, it will become a law, or he can choose to veto it. I have faith that he's going to sign it, and I think we all have faith that he will sign it, which brings me to my next point. We'll need all of your help to get closer to the assembly floor to make sure that we're allowing and giving the message to the assembly members to let them know how important it is for us to, you know, spread the urgency of this bill and the opportunities that this bill will provide. It is important for us to rally together to allow the assembly members, you know, to give the assembly members knowledge of them knowing that, you know, and then this is going to affect a lot of people, you know, almost 5,000 Californians. And so with us working together, I have faith that we'll pass sunsets next year. Okay, Gilbert.
Hey, as a man of faith, I'm gonna connect my faith with your faith, and we're gonna put that faith in action, because faith without works is dead. Don't let me get the preaching in here on y'all. I'm trying to tell you, we are fully invested into this work, and the brother meant 5,000 convictions, close to 5,000 collateral consequences or barriers that are placing our people in post-conviction poverty, y'all. That is ridiculousness. And when we talk about the 8 million people across the state of California and the 70 to 100 million people across the entire United States living with an old felony or misdemeanor, y'all, this work is going to truly transform lives. We got to get this passed. We got to stay in the fight to pass even stronger legislation in the future after we win sunsets. You know, I got the word alive in my spirit. This work keeps me alive. It keeps me going. They told me I wasn't going to make it to the age of 18. Here I am, 37, married, 5 kids, working with amazing people like Tanisha, Jay, Christopher, Terrence, John, the Monterosa sisters, y'all. This is amazing, dynamic work that I never thought I'd be doing. And Time Done CSJ is providing so many opportunities for our folks to excel, thrive, lead, build, win, progress, all of that, y'all. So let's keep it going. I want to bring up my brother who's going to bless us with some dope flows. He's representing Oakland, the Yay area. The fabulous Yay area, Oakland, Big John, representing legal services for prisoners with children. He's a policy fellow up there holding it down, doing amazing work. All of us are none. Big shout out to Dorsey Nunn. Big shout out to Geronimo, Henry Ortiz, all of us are none network. I'll be moderating a panel for All of Us are None next Tuesday. So I'm excited about that. Y'all know we connected. Because the more we flex our collaborative muscle, the more power we have collectively. And so, John, he's also a Time Done delegate. Very excited to have you here, brother. Let the people know a little bit about yourself and then bless them with them flows, player.
Yeah, first off, it's a blessing to be in a space like this, man, with people that's just like me, man. You know what I'm saying? So just a little about myself, too. I went to prison when I was 16. They certified me as an adult, and I did 10 years altogether. So, you know, now just getting out and being able to fight for the people that I left inside, and even to fight for the people that's out here with convictions, man, it's really dope to be in this space. But I gotta put the music on right now. This song is called No Exceptions. Hopefully y'all hear it. Yeah.
He ain't gripped the rim, his hammer, but for what though? Hard to be inspired when your environment is cut though. Threw us in the fire, but we survived, and it's up though. Before we smell flowers, yeah, we knew the smell of gun smoke. Grandma used to say, the darker you is, the harder life. It always made me shed a tear, cause grandma dark as night. They taught us self-hate, and now she's scarred for life. Concrete jungle, we could barely see the stars at night. Throughout distractions, now they acting like we can't see. Let us off them plantations, but we ain't free. They say it's hard to see the picture when you in the frame. I make this bitch come to life, watch how you paint me. It's called No Exceptions. Stole this land from the natives. Fuck it's Thanksgiving. First they enslaved us, then went and taught us their religion. Fuck these history books, I know it's pages missing. I can see through their lies, I got the laser vision. It's hard to make a way unless you rich and white. Sleepwalking in the day, the pain hit at night. I know this poverty and trauma is a big monster, so I don't even judge my neighbor when he hit the pipe. Begging for your rights, that's like standing at a pool fishing. You just wasting your time, you need to move different. Fuck the system, they be thinking that it's cool snitching. Master pat you on your back, now you a stool pigeon. Bro, keep fighting, you don't lose when you tumble. Pick yourself up, brother, lace your shoes when you rumble. After the Panthers, they hit us with the crack. Now it's time to shake back, we ain't removed from the struggle. No exceptions. What they do, label us as gangs when we together. They want you alone, then hit you with them gang enhancements. They'll do you wrong. Little baby left me stranded in them cages. I ain't mad at her, guess she wasn't down to kiss me through the phone. From project living to a prison, it's a big business. They whole mission is to create division. Be loyal to your soil, gotta stay consistent. They talk down, we don't listen when them snakes is hissing. The system turning brown and black kids to orphans. Now little man running scams just to get his portion. Feel like patience is a privilege, he can't hold his horses. On Instagram, so all he think about is girls and Porsches. They know this shit right, but they won't support this. We still running from cops like they got ropes and torches. Use your eyes and you can see your protection. We won't stop till we free, baby. No exceptions. Appreciate it, y'all. That's the song. I appreciate everybody's time and everybody listening. Y'all can check it out. It's called No Exceptions.
Appreciate you. Like, that was awesome. I was listening to the words that you were spitting and didn't want to get super emotional. Hi, everybody. I'm Lynesha Edwards, the Los Angeles chapter coordinator. Again, Los Angeles is feeling really bayish up in here. It is my honor and my pleasure to introduce San Francisco natives, Michelle and Ashley Monterosa. Michelle and Ashley Monterosa are the surviving sisters of Sean Monterosa, who was killed by the Vallejo Police Department. Michelle and Ashley are our CSSJ chapter coordinators working to build, develop, win, and heal with community, here to share their story and provide some SB 299 policy updates. My sisters, Michelle and Ashley, welcome.
Hi everyone, such an honor to be here in space with you all. As you know, I'm Michelle Monterosa.
And I'm Ashley Monterosa.
And we're the surviving sisters of our brother, Sean Monterosa, who was murdered by Officer Jared Ton of the Vallejo Police Department on June 2nd. And we've been turning our pain to power. You know, we're finding purpose in this fight. And today we want to give you guys an update on two bills we've been working on supporting. Just want to extend our gratitude to Tanish for, you know, bringing us on board and, you know, seeing our fight and our drive. And, you know, we're not only fighting for my brother, we're fighting for all families impacted by state violence. So SB 299, the California legislature is in interim recess until January 3rd. When they return, they will begin the two-part legislative session and take up bills. We have two CSSJ bills that will be eligible to move forward next January when the legislature returns. January, our sunset bills, SB 731 by Senator Durazo, unfortunately did not pass the assembly, for, as Chris had mentioned before. SB 299 by Senator Leyva is our bill that will give victims of police violence and other violent crimes greater access to California's victims compensation program that will start on the assembly floor next year. The bill will require 54 votes to pass assembly floor. And as of now, we need to secure a few more votes to get there. So stay tuned on ways to support the action, make calls, tweet, any way that we can uplift this bill. Over the next several months, we will need all of your help to share with assembly members why this bill is important to the movement to provide healing and support to all survivors. Our other CSSJ bill that is still alive is our bereavement bill, AB 95, by Assemblymember Lowe.
AB 95 will ensure protected unpaid bereavement leave for people who lose a close family member. AB 95 will pass out of assembly appropriations and into the assembly floor by the end of next January. Both of these bills are in strong positions to get to the governor, but we will need all hands on deck to support the bills with advocacy visits, phone banking, and support letters. So we hope back in January, once everything opens back up with the legislation, you can all continue to support us in these efforts and get SB 299, SB 731, and AB 95 signed into law, because we know how necessary all of these are.
And then, you know, if you guys have time to make it to Sacramento and we pack those rooms so they hear all of our voices, you know, stay tuned. Keep following Safe and Just and Crime Survivor Safety and Justice to stay tuned on ways to uplift both of these bills, all three bills. And just thank you guys and happy Thursday?
Friday Junior, everyone. And thank you all for being here and listening to all the bill updates.
What's up, y'all? Hey, happy Friday, Junior. I like that. That's cute. As y'all can see, I am in the place to be this evening. I am so excited. Anytime I get to link up with my time done folks, I'm always super duper excited and just happy to be here. So we're going to go right into this next piece. I have the blessed opportunity. Well, first of all, y'all know who I am. I'm Tay. I'm Tashante McCoy. I'm part of the membership engagement team for Alliance for Safety and Justice. But y'all know I'm so stocked in. So I have the blessed opportunity to introduce the next person that's going to be coming up and spitting that reel. So Aaron is a father, a mentor, a community leader, a lyricist, a poet. But to me, he's my brother, like my right-hand man in the community. And I'm always so excited to hear what he has to say. So without further ado, I give to y'all Aaron.
What's up, y'all? How y'all doing? Big blessings. Yeah, as Tay said, as Big Sis Tay said, my name's Aaron T. I'm a community activist, poet, mentor, and just someone trying to make sure our community is better every single day. You know, survival is real, you feel me? And we got to make sure we keep pushing and being survivors out here and not letting everything get in the way. With that said, the poem that I'll be doing is called What's a Dry Cup? What's an empty cup to a thirsty soul? Bone dry looking for saturation. The promise of hydration equated to hope. Some days I look at the world and see a desert, empty and lifeless. The people left look like zombies, flesh dehydrated, mind on everything but Jesus, destructively looking to feed cravings, leaving the land more bare than they found it. The oases are few and far in between. Trauma makes the heart weary. The mind replaying every moment, plucking the tender strings of our souls. Music consoles, but often reminds. Drugs and alcohol seem to create an equilibrium. There's a thin line between sanity and insanity. Simone Biles will struggle to balance this beam. Our world talks about self-care. Healing narratives seem to roll off tongues like raindrops off rooftops. If you ask Shikari Richardson, the world talks the talk but would never run that mile. So where you go to fill your cup? Too many of us don't know. We assume the well is a location, searching for it like El Dorado, falling for the fable like fool's gold. Truth be told, it was written in the stars. The ancestors say follow the drinking gourd. God gave us the coordinates to our own salvation, placing stars that map out the sky, pointing back to the only place that's never moving, and it only looks different from the position in which you stand. Your soul. So what's a dry cup to a thirsty soul? The definition of faith. The audacity of hope. Holding it upright. Waiting for the rain to come. Adjusting the cup high as it's the search for a phone signal. Making steps toward the river. But every moment it's like trucking through quicksand. Only wanting what God has promised. Let the water be the answer. And your cup be filled. One drop at a time. As time and practice heal your wounds. As time and practice breaks generational traumas. As time and practice erases hate. As time and practice builds love to the survivor. Speak life. Speak your truth. And let your words hold up your cup. Because God reigns daily. And that's my piece, y'all.
Well, Aaron, I'm over here trying to get myself together. First of all, I want you to know I was taking notes because, I mean, just the beauty of that poem and the realness that you brought to this space was so needed, brother. So thank you so much for sharing those words. Thank you so much for setting the tone because everything you said is on point right now. You know, so many of us are weary from the trauma that we've experienced in our communities and our families. Many of us are still going through it. I'm speaking from personal experience. The weight, you know, of what we're experiencing right now is heavy. It's a heavy, heavy load. But we have the audacity to still have hope, the audacity to still be fighting. You know what I'm saying? When we started this, I'm a little thrown off, y'all, because I'm in Atlanta right now for the NCVC conference for crime victims. And, you know, I'm a little thrown off because we 3 hours ahead and I'm a Cali girl, so I don't know what time it is right now. But that poem grounded me. It brought me back to center. And that's what this work does for us. That's what this movement does for us. That's what spaces like this do for us. It brings us back to center. It reminds us of why we're here and what we're trying to do. We're trying to quench that thirst that we have for liberation, for freedom in our communities. We are working day and night to quench this thirst that we have for justice. You know, we just heard from the Monte Rosa sisters, two powerful young women that I love. And I'm so proud of all of the time done delegates. You know what I'm saying? Christopher, who came in here earlier, giving that remarkable bill update. You know, we are training up our people. We are elevating our people to be able to not just be in part of conversations, but to lead these conversations about what needs to change in our society, what needs to change in our communities so that we can achieve safety. And not at our own expense, that these solutions and the resources, the money, the funds, they don't keep going to things that create more harm, more trauma, more barriers for us. These bills that we are pushing forward are historic. They are life-giving. They are life-changing. And we've been able to inspire that hope through stories, you know, from survivor leaders like Mama Stephanie out in Stockton, California, who's been fighting for justice for her son, Antoine Baris, and is now a chapter coordinator in Stockton. So proud of the leadership that's emerging, of all the time done delegates who are about to graduate in just a couple weeks, who have been working nonstop this year to learn as much as they can, to share their stories about how this bill, SB 731, when it passes, not if it passes, what kind of change it's going to lead to in our community. That's what safety really is. We don't need systems to keep defining for us what safety looks like. We have the solutions, and that's why these bills are so important. But if you know, like I know where I'm from, we don't stay down for too long. We might bend, but we ain't gonna break. This work in front of us is critical, and we're the ones that have to lead it. It's on us to move these bills forward through the legislature. It's on us to impress upon these lawmakers, on our governor, on the folks who are with us in community, the importance of these bills making their way through. We are tired of fighting for our humanity. It doesn't make sense for us to have to keep explaining why it makes sense to restore rights to people who have been disenfranchised their entire lives, many of them. And what that does for public safety when people can't get access to jobs and housing and take care of their families, it's a no-brainer. We have work to do. And the same thing for our survivors. It makes perfect sense that when someone experiences a harm, although we want to get to a place where people are not being harmed in their communities, but when you do, that you get help right away. That we don't have to get out here in the streets and do a GoFundMe to raise money to bury our loved ones or fight with systems to recognize us as victims who deserve support. It's time done for all of that. So I'm excited about the momentum that we're building here in California. I'm excited that very soon we're going to be coming together in person in our chapters at our retreats to talk more about how we're going to move this legislation forward, how we're going to keep advancing this change. Oh, and y'all not ready for 2022 because we just getting warmed up. So I'm going to leave it there because I want to fill your cup with some hope. I want to fill your cup with and get your wheels turning about the audacity of looking toward the future for what more we can do, because there's so much more for us to do, and we are the right people in the right place in the right time that have been ordained to do it. So let's get cracking, y'all. Let's get to work. I want to thank everyone who tuned in tonight for this movement momentum. I want to thank my brother Gilbert Johnson, because as much as he has uplifted me and seasoned me, I have to tell you what a privilege it is to work side by side with this brother and to see the way that he is impacting lives by creating opportunities for leadership for people. Is just, ain't no words to describe it. But what it will lead to, the impact that it's going to make, is going to be felt for generations. So thank you, Gilbert. Thank you to Team CSJ, CSSJ. Thank you to LaNaysha, Tay, my dog up here in Northern California. You know I love everybody in the Valley and everybody on the back end. Julie V, our digital manager here. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. Looking forward to seeing you on the ground when we start making these calls, when we start doing these visits. We start applying this pressure to get these bills across the finish line. And we know you're going to be right there with us. The marathon continues. Y'all have a good night.